How have we changed in the past 4 years? Steven?
The past 4 years, I've changed from being a fatty into being normal, and then being fat again, and then I changed back to normal, and now I'm fat again.
You live in Marysville, too.
And I live in Marysville.
Have a nice job.
And I have a job, and I'm making bank.
This dude. Well, I came in freshman year with hair down to here. And now I got this. It's nice.
Shaved my head. I read a lot. I went from football to cross country, and then swimming and track. And I chose the Marines over the Army, Mr. McLeod.
Definitely become more confident with who I am. I definitely think that I have changed based on I've got a lot more confidence.
I would definitely say the biggest change that I've made in the last 4 years is obviously my hair. I had really bad hair, and I don't know why anybody didn't tell me about it, but got that straightened out, and we good now, so.
How have I changed in the past 4 years? Well, they told me that was one of the questions, but I think that's just their way of saying, how much weight have you actually gained in the past 4 years? Well, in eighth grade, I'll go 5 years. I was 5'10" tall, and I weighed 207. Now I'm 6'4", and I weigh 295. So I guess I've gained about 90 pounds.
I'm here live with Lucas Heath. How have you changed in the past 4 years?
I don't think I've really changed the last 4 years. I think I've stayed pretty much the same person. I haven't really changed that much.
How have I changed in the last 4 years? Well, I've got a white beard. But really, I got taller and smarter. My brain's way more gooder than it was. Well, I'm getting older too. So take this love and take it down.
Yeah, and if you climb a mountain and you turn around, and if you see my reflection in the snow.
My senior year has definitely been my favorite. I've been able to participate a lot more. There's a lot more freedom, and I know that next year I'll be going off to college, which is always a plus.
My favorite year by far, senior year. It is completely everything it's cracked up to be. It is the bomb. It's perfect. It's just awesome. Senior year, live it up.
I had a lot of fun. I sleep in almost all my classes, which is great because I'm a senior and I can do that.
Worst case of senioritis ever.
Yeah.
Which year has been my favorite? Probably the year Mr. McLeod came, to be honest.
My favorite teacher is Mr. Brunswick. We've had him for the past 4 years. We came in as a freshman AI, a bunch of immature little losers. Still are, but we like to have fun now, and he's caught on to how we act. And he calls me fat. A lot of fat jokes, but I accept it because he's funny and makes me happy some days. Steven, who's your favorite?
I like all the teachers. Because teachers are great. I want to be one day.
My favorite teachers, definitely Mr. Robinson, Mr. Miller, and then Mrs. Mount.
Probably a tie between Caudill, Brunswick, and Stanford. Those are my teachers.
Favorite teacher would have to be Mrs. Mount. Mine would have to be J-Rob.
For my favorite teacher, it definitely has to be G-Dub. I didn't even have him when he was actually a teacher. I've had him for like a month, I think, and by far the best teacher I've ever had. And for it being so fun, I learned so much in his class, and he's just a great guy. Love him. Love you, G-Dub.
My favorite teacher in all high school is definitely this guy right here. Best teacher ever. Yeah.
Need some love.
In high school, I've had one favorite teacher, and that's probably Mr. Brunswick, just because he's so laid back and that fact. Yeah, I owe you all one punch, so get you at the end of the year.
You know, my favorite teacher is Coach Schmidt. He shows good chieftain pride. He knows what it takes to be a chieftain. That's my favorite teacher.
There.
My favorite high school memory is winning the CBC Ooh. In soccer. Definitely.
Mine would have to be Preston at Government Day.
I got too many to count, but I think my favorite one would be graduating, because I'm probably going to trip down the stairs or something. But it'll be good.
I think my favorite high school memory definitely has to be this year during my senior soccer season. In the tournaments, we were down 2-0 against Greenan, and then we came back and beat them 4-2, and I scored the last goal, and the goal, it was an open goal, and I fist pumped all the way down the field. That definitely has to be a highlight of my high school career.
My favorite high school memory has to be when they actually served fries. Man, I love those fries. So golden. So golden. I mean, then they had hash browns and baked fries. I can't do this.
All right, my favorite high school memory is probably when the Lady Chiefs of 2010 won the CBC championship, because it was great.
My favorite memory, high school memory, would definitely be physics class, just all of the experiments that we did, like the race cars track and the Rube Goldberg. It was fantastic.
My favorite high school memory would have to be this year at Solon Ensemble when Smalley fell down the stairs in front of everybody in heels.
I knew you were gonna say that.
Cut.
I've been walking in the same way as I did, missing out the cracks in the pavement and tutting my heel and strutting my
feet. You once went a whole 2 weeks without seeing sunlight.
It was awesome. I turned white. It's
like,
kind of scary.
Like that. That
white. Imagine me being pulse colored.
My color.
It was scary.
And then football, of course, lifting, and I wrestled.
I did track and baseball one time in my life.
Got football, freshman, sophomore year. Cross country, junior, senior year. Track, junior, senior year. Swimming, best sport, only my senior year though. TV production, pretty awesome, sophomore, senior year. I'm enlisted. That's really not a school activity though. I was an escort. That was pretty fun.
Art club, choir, musical, LaFon's, yearbook.
Some things that I've been involved with in my high school career here at Bell Fountain High School. Haven't really been any extracurricular activities, but there has been some SAT, some detention, some suspension, some stop, and maybe if I'm lucky, a expulsion here in my near future.
Shows that we ain't gonna stand shit, shows that we are united. Run my hometown, making memories, I pray.
If I could relive one moment of high school, it would probably have to be when I dusted Sean Agler in the 100 meter.
Mine would be the last pass of the overtime against Tecumseh sophomore year.
I'm gonna relive the game-saving tackle of Sydney.
If I could relive any moment in high school, I would definitely my junior year. We were playing Marysville in football. It was at Marysville, and we made my huge sign that said D1 with a question mark, and we held it up after we beat them, and it was just a great feeling and good times.
Oh, my world, yeah, oh, my world. Oh, my world, yeah.
Get involved in everything that you can. It really does go quick, and just have a good time.
Advice to underclassmen is don't do drugs. They're really bad for you.
And do not drink and drive. You'll die.
Yeah.
As cliche as it sounds and oversaid, live high school up because it goes by really fast, and you don't really realize it when it's happening, but it's over pretty quick, so really live it up. Everyone says that, but it's true. It goes by quick.
You know, just live life to the fullest and get nutty.
I would have to say just get involved. Just have as much fun as you can and participate in anything and everything that interests you.
If there's any advice I could give to the younger classmen, that would definitely be involved in sports. Like, if you want to do something, do it. Because in college, you most likely won't be able to do that. So in high school, just take your chances and do what you want to do. Have fun.
If I had to give the underclassmen some advice, it would probably be to get good grades, because scholarships definitely help.
Stay out of trouble, because you can't soar with the Eagles if you're hooting with the Owls.
Promises we made, one by one they vanish just the same. All the things I still remember so.
worth it in the end. Now it all seems so clear, there's nothing left to fear. So we made our way by finding what was real. Now the days are so long, that summer's moving on. Chapter ends, a new one now begins. Time has come for letting go. The hardest part is when you know all of these years when we were here are ending, but I'll always remember we have had the time of our lives, and now the pages turn. The stories we will write. We have had the time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to walk away from the best of days, but if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. Where the water meets the land, there is shifting in the sand. Like the tide that ebbs and flows, memories will come and go. All of these years when we were but I'll always remember we have had the time of our lives, and now the pages turn, the stories we will write. We have had the time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. Best of days. times to these memories that never die. We have had the time of our lives, and now the pages turned, the stories we will write. We have had the time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to walk away from the best of days, but if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our life.